This is the H2SO3 Lewis structure, sulfurous acid. The key to understanding this Lewis structure is to recognize these two H's in front attached to a polyatomic ion. That makes it an acid. And these oxygens here, the hydrogens, will attach to the outside of the oxygens. So we'll put our sulfur here in the middle. It's the least electronegative. We have three oxygens. And for the two hydrogens, we said those would be on the outside, like this right here. We have a total of 26 valence electrons for the H2SO4 Lewis structure. We'll put two electrons between atoms to form the chemical bonds there. We've used 10 valence electrons. Then we'll fill the octets on the oxygens. So you have 10, 12, 24, and then back to the center, 26. So we've used all 26 valence electrons, and everything in this structure, in the H2SO4 Lewis structure, has a full outer shell. So it looks like a pretty good Lewis structure. Thing is, when you see sulfur, sulfur is in period 3 on the periodic table, sulfur can hold more than 8 valence electrons. So we really need to look at the formal charges for this molecule. When we calculate the formal charges, the sulfur has a +1 charge and the oxygen has a -1 charge. So we'd like our formal charges to be as close to 0 as possible. And to do that, we can move this pair of valence electrons between the oxygen and the sulfur to form a double bond. By doing so, we're still only using 26 valence electrons, but now the formal charges on all of the atoms are 0, and that makes for a much more stable Lewis structure for H2SO4. So if you see the sulfur there, you'll want to check your formal charges. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.